Dear children, we can learn the first lesson from the Polity's textbook, that is power sharing. Power means strength. In this lesson, power means authority. Power sharing means sharing of power or delegation of power or division of power or delegation of authority. Okay. In order to understand the term power sharing, they have given the examples of two countries, Belgium and Sri Lanka. We know that power sharing is the best technique to do each and every activity. If we share or if we delegate the authority to somebody else, we can do the activities in the best way. That for a small instance, the school assembly, that's also we are doing power sharing on the basis of houses or on the basis of classes. We are conducting the assembly, otherwise it will be a difficult task, isn't it? Like that, power sharing is the best technique to administer the country in the best way. So in order to understand the term power sharing, they are giving the examples of two countries. First one, Belgium. Belgium is a small country in Europe, smaller in area than the state of Haryana. Haryana is only a state of India. You know, India is a vast country having 28 states and 8 union territories. Haryana is only a state of India. And the population of Belgium is half the population of Haryana. That is only 1 crore. Haryana itself has 2 crore people. Belgium has only 1 crore people. And in the Belgium, the ethnic composition of Belgium is very complex. Ethnic means social division on the basis of shared culture. Okay, the ethnic composition of Belgium is very complex. Of the total population, 59% people speak Dutch and they live in the Flemish region. And 40% people speak French and they live in the Wallonia region. And the remaining 1% people speak German language. And the capital city of Brussels is, capital of Belgium is the Brussels. Brussels is the capital of Belgium. In the capital city Brussels, there 80% people speak French and 20% people speak Dutch. Vice versa to the country. When we consider the total country, majority people are Dutch speakers, and in the Brussels, majority people are French speakers. That is the situation of Belgium. And the minority people are French speakers in the country. The minority French speaking people are relatively rich and powerful, or comparatively they were rich and powerful. Therefore, the economic development and education goes to Dutch speakers much later. They didn't get any economic development or education. That is the situation of Belgium. Therefore, there arises a tension between the two communities. That is the French speakers and Dutch speakers. There arises a conflict between the two communities, or tension between the two communities, during 1950s and 60s. The tension became so acute in Brussels, that because Brussels has a special problem. 80% people are French speakers. They are rich and powerful. Only they got the education development and economic development. Therefore, the tension became so acute in Brussels. That is the ethnic composition of Belgium. Okay, then we can learn about Sri Lanka. You know, Sri Lanka is an island nation. ഇതിന് തന്നെ ഒന്ന് മലയാളത്തിൽ നമുക്ക് പറഞ്ഞുതരാം. മനസ്സിലാവുന്ന രീതിയിൽ ഒന്നുകൂടെ മലയാളത്തിൽ മനസ്സിലായിട്ടില്ലെങ്കിൽ മലയാളത്തിൽ ഞാൻ ഒന്നുകൂടെ പറഞ്ഞുതരാം. ശ്രീലങ്ക ഈസ് എൻ ഐലൻഡ് നേഷൻ ജസ്റ്റ് എ ഫ്യൂ കിലോമീറ്റേഴ്സ് എവേ ഫ്രം ദ സ്റ്റേറ്റ് ഓഫ് തമിഴ്നാടു. ഇറ്റ്സ് എ പോപ്പുലേഷൻ ഈസ് 2 crore. ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് ആ സെയിം ആസ് ഹരിയാന. ഹരിയാന ആൾസോ ഹാസ് ഓൺലി 2 crore പീപ്പിൾ. ശ്രീലങ്ക ആൾസോ ഹാസ് ഓൺലി 2 crore people. Then we can think that the accommodation of Sri Lanka is also very easy. We can wait and see. After learning the lesson, we can say that is it was easy or difficult. The leaders of Sinhala speakers sought to secure dominance over the majority of their majority. Understand? The leaders of the Sinhala speakers sought to secure dominance over the majority. Dominance over the Sinhala speakers by considering the majority people. Always they are giving more importance to Sinhala speakers only. For that, in 1956, an act was passed in Sri Lanka. According to that act, only Sinhala was declared as the official language of Sri Lanka by disregarding the Tamil speakers. They declared Sinhala as the, an act was passed in 1956 to establish Sinhala as the only official language of Sri Lanka by disregarding the Tamils. They are not ready, the Sinhala speakers are not ready to, or the constitution of the government in the leadership of Sinhala speakers are not ready to give any consideration to the Tamil speakers. That was the main problem existed in Sri Lanka. And the 7% Christians are also there. They speak both the Sinhala and the Tamil. Most of the, not most, all the Sinhala speakers are Buddhist. On the basis of religion also, we can see some social division there. All the Sinhala speakers are Buddhist. The Tamil speakers are Muslims and Hindus. 7% Christians are also there. They speak both the Sinhala and the Tamil. All the government measures coming one after the other felt among the Tamil speakers, they are an alien in the country. All the government measures coming one after the other felt among the Tamil speakers, they were an alien. Videshi, alien means Videshi. They are an, were an alien in the country. This reason, therefore, there arises a distrust between, or there arises a conflict among the Sinhala speakers and the Tamil speakers. Therefore, the Sinhala, the Sri Lankan Tamils launched a party, partisan struggles for the recognition of Tamil as an official language. They demanded, the political party, they formed some political parties and they demanded to declare Tamil as an official language, and they wanted regional autonomy. They wanted to create a Tamil state, a separate Tamil Elam. Elam means Tamil state. For the Tamil speakers only, they wanted a separate Tamil state. All these demands were continuously denied by the Sinhala speakers government or the constitution of the country. A new constitution was also stipulated by the Sinhala speakers to protect and foster Buddhism only. They told that only Buddhists can protect and foster. No consideration was given to Hindus or Muslims. That was the main social division we can see in the country. The leaders were not ready to admit the demands of the Tamil speakers. Therefore, a distrust between the two communities occurred, a civil war in the Sri Lanka. Do you know what is the meaning of civil war? Civil war means war among the people within the country. World war means war between, war among different countries, or war between different countries are called world war. In Sri Lanka, the distrust between the two communities causes a civil war. In the civil war, thousands of people from the two communities have been killed. Thousands of people have lost their livelihood. Thousands of people have been went to different countries or another countries as refugees. You know, Sri Lanka was very excellent in their economic situations, social, their culture was very excellent, and their educational and health care, every situation, every field, they were very excellent. But after the civil war, everything was set back. We can see a setback in the cultural, economical and social situations in Sri Lanka. We can see a disintegration of the country has happened there. That was the situation of Sri Lanka after the majoritarian measures taken in Sri Lanka. Both these countries, about Belgium, what accommodation they have been done, that we didn't learn, we can learn that in the next topic. Okay. So, we have learned about the ethnic compositions of Belgium and Sri Lanka. Belgium, we learned that it's different kinds of social divisions we have seen there on the basis of language, on the basis of religion, and on the basis of region. In Sri Lanka also, we have seen different kinds of ethnic compositions or social divisions on the basis of languages, on the basis of region, and on the basis of religion. But the leaders of Sri Lanka was not ready to share the power. That's why there occurred the civil war and the undermine or set back all the situations of the country. That is the situation of Sri Lanka. ഇനി ഇതിന്റെ മലയാളം ഞാൻ ഒന്ന് പറഞ്ഞുതരാം. ബെൽജിയം ഒരു ചെറിയ രാജ്യമാണ്. പലതരത്തിലുള്ള സാമൂഹിക വൈരുദ്ധ്യങ്ങൾ നമുക്ക് അവിടെ കാണാൻ കഴിയും. ഇന്ത്യയിൽ ഇത്രയും വൈരുദ്ധ്യങ്ങൾ ഉണ്ടായിട്ടും നമ്മൾ ഭാരതം എന്ന പേര് കേട്ടാൽ ഇപ്പോഴും നമ്മൾ അഭിമാനിക്കുകയാണ്. കേരളം എന്ന് പേര് കേട്ടാലോ തിളക്കണം ചോര നരമ്പുകളിൽ, ആൻഡ് ഭാരതം എന്ന് കേട്ടാലോ അഭിമാനപൂരിതമാകുമെന്ന് അന്തരംഗം എന്നാണ് നമ്മൾ പഠിച്ചിട്ടുള്ളത്. അപ്പൊ ഈ ഡൈവേഴ്സിറ്റീസ് എല്ലാം ബെൽജിയം എങ്ങനെ അക്കോമഡേറ്റ് ചെയ്തു, എങ്ങനെയാണ് അവിടെ നേതാക്കന്മാർ ചെയ്തതെന്ന് നമ്മൾ പഠിക്കും. ശ്രീലങ്ക നമ്മൾ ഓൾറെഡി ഇന്ന് തന്നെ പഠിച്ചു കഴിഞ്ഞു. ശ്രീലങ്കയിലാണെങ്കിൽ ഇത്രയും ഡൈവേഴ്സിറ്റീസ് ഉണ്ടായിട്ടും അവിടുത്തെ ശ്രീലങ്കൻ സ്പീക്കേഴ്സ് അത് ഷെയർ ചെയ്യാനേ തയ്യാറായില്ല. തമിഴ് സ്പീക്കേഴ്സ് മൂന്ന് ഡിമാൻഡാണ് അവർ വെച്ചത്. ഒന്ന്, അവർക്ക് ഒരു പ്രത്യേകം തമിഴ് സ്റ്റേറ്റ് വേണം. പിന്നെ അവർക്ക് തമിഴിനെ ഒഫീഷ്യൽ ലാംഗ്വേജ് ആയിട്ട് പ്രഖ്യാപിക്കണം. പിന്നെ അവർക്ക് എഡ്യൂക്കേഷനും എംപ്ലോയ്മെന്റ് ഓപ്പർച്യൂണിറ്റീസും ജോബ് ഓപ്പർച്യൂണിറ്റീസും ഒക്കെ വേണം എന്നാണ് അവർ ആവശ്യം. ഇതൊന്നും അവർ കൊടുത്തില്ല. അങ്ങനെ രാജ്യത്ത് സിവിൽ വാർ പൊട്ടിപ്പുറപ്പെട്ട് രാജ്യം ചിന്നഭിന്നമായി പോയി എന്നാണ് നമുക്ക് കാണാൻ കഴിഞ്ഞ, പവർ ഷെയർ ചെയ്യാതിരുന്നതിനാൽ. ഓക്കെ മൈ ഡിയർ സ്റ്റുഡൻസ്, ബൈ.